You know, as the snow is melting away and spring's on its way, it's a great time to get out there and get a little fertilizer on the lawn. And I've got a lot of different options what you can do. But we've got our five-step lawn program here at Anderson Seed and Garden. And the five-step lawn program kind of walks you through the basics. You know, usually around St. Patrick's Day through Easter is a great time to put your first application on. Otherwise, the 1st of April through the end of April. You know, it's just easier to remember by the holidays. So just remember, you know, sometime before Easter, we want to get that first application of fertilizer on there. We have a lot of different options for you. You can do just a straight fertilizer like 16-16-16, or you can put fertilizer weed preventer, you know, with a pre-emergent in there on. That's a great time to put that on around the first part of April. So one of our favorites is the Fertilome Weed and Feed with Dimension. Great fertilizer, excellent pre-emergent. But what I want to talk about right now is there's a very unique product that's out there that will help kill weeds that have wintered over from last year. So usually a broadleaf weed killer, you know, 2,4-D or Trimec or Weed Be Gone, you know, any of those, you need much warmer temperatures for those to work. But in the last couple of years, some newer herbicides have come out, some newer weed killers that will kill weeds in much cooler temperatures. And we've got one of those in our first step of our lawn program, and it's called Weed Free Zone. Now, the Weed Free Zone, it comes in a granulated fertilizer. So we've got Weed Free Zone right here. Great fertilizer, slow release nitrogen. It's got 5% iron in there, some sulfur to really help green the lawn up and get it looking good without making it grow out of control. So mostly slow release nitrogen. But the weed killer that's in here is called Weed Free Zone. And the Weed Free Zone will kill all kinds of broadleaf weeds. Morning glory, wild violets, thistles, mallow, clover, dandelions, I mean, you name it, it'll take care of it. It works in cooler temperatures, so it works in temperatures as low as 50 degrees for your daytime temperatures, where most of the other broadleaf weed killers need to have 65, 70, 75 degree temperatures for them to work properly. But the Weed Free Zone will work in those cooler temperatures, so it works great when the weather's colder, but we still need dry weather, so we can't put the Weed Free Zone on when it's going to rain every day. We got to wait until we see some nice weather where you can get that put out there. But even if the temperatures are cooler, this will work. And like I said, it works on the hardest to kill weeds that are out there. Morning glory, wild violets, thistles, and does a great job. With a weed and feed like this, you want to make sure and put it on when the grass is damp. You want to leave it on for 24 hours, and then you want to go ahead and water it sometime after the 24 hours. If the temperatures are cooler, it's not a big issue. If it doesn't get watered in immediately, it can go a day or two before it gets watered. But it really needs to be watered in after the 24 hours. So don't just put it on and water it in, because it's not going to kill any weeds. It has to stay on for 24 hours before it gets watered in. Otherwise, it's not going to kill weeds very well. But the fertilizer will still work. So the fertilizer will work great. If you want to kill weeds, which is what we're using the product for in the first place, make sure you put it on when the grass is damp, leave it on for 24 hours, and then water it after that. If you've already put a fertilizer on, or you want to use a fertilizer with a pre-emergent combo in it, but you still have a few weeds that you want to take care of, use the liquid. The Weed Free Zone in the liquid form is probably even more effective than the weed and feed, just because the liquid seems to penetrate into the weeds better. Again, temperature-wise, 45 to 50 degrees for a high temperature is all you need during the day, and then you know, it will work up to about 90 degrees. So if it gets hotter than that, we're gonna have we'll have problems this early. But it's not gonna get that hot this early. So during the summer, you gotta watch out a little bit if it gets too hot. But for right now, the Weed Free Zone, cooler temperatures, works on the hardest to kill weeds. Comes in a liquid form like this, so you can use your hose end sprayer, you can use a pump up sprayer, and it's going to take out your hardest to kill weeds very quickly, even in cooler temperatures. Again, make sure it stays on for probably 12 to 24 hours before it gets watered in, so it can really do its thing and work properly. So we've got a couple very good options for some early season weed control. Don't forget about our lawn care program, so our five-step program. First application should go on sometime between St. Patrick's Day and Easter. And you know, if you can't remember the holidays, but most everybody does, first part of April through the end of April is a great time to get that first application on. And we got a lot of different options for you, especially the Weed Free Zone or a fertilizer with pre-emergent, or just a great fertilizer. Just be sure and get something on your lawn and get things going for spring, and before you know it, your lawn will be green and beautiful and ready for summer.